Hey, hello, Rana. Welcome to Let's Learn. Feels good to reach out to you with another video. Thank you very much for staying connected during this passive period. Today, we have an interesting topic to discuss. We're going to talk about words. Words that define the decade. So when I say decade, it is from 2011 to 2020. We'll be discussing one word per year. On what basis do we select a word for a year? These words could be the one which describes the events of the year or the most used or the most searched words. It is selected based on voting by the English speakers and dictionary users. Interestingly, this decade saw a contrasting set of words between the first half and the second half. Social media dominated the first half and political, environmental and humanitarian topics highlighted the second half. So, here we go with my top 10 words of the decade. The first word is pragmatic. When the time came for deciding the word for 2011, it was decided to be pragmatic. The word pragmatic means practical and logical. Though there is no specific reason for this decision, it is told that the word was increasingly used in political discussions and thereby became popular in day-to-day conversations. Next year saw the beginning of social media having its impact on people and their language as well. Though hashtag is now a common term, its strong online presence was first felt back in 2012. Used in Twitter, and hashtag refers to the practice of using the hash symbol followed by a topic to identify them easily. And people started to use hashtags for everything. And internet has seen a lot of interesting hashtags over a period of time. Our next word is selfie. Selfie was first a hashtag used in Twitter, and it evolved to be a term for self-portrait photograph. Interestingly, people became inventive with selfies, and this added a lot of new terms into English like welfie, which is a workout selfie, drelfie, which is a drunken selfie, and the famous group selfie got the term Uzi. Let's not even discuss mirror selfie now. Do you intentionally spoil your friend's perfect photograph moment by jumping into the frame? And did you enjoy doing so? This means you love to photobomb. Well, it is this habit of spoiling a photograph by appearing in front of the camera, just like this gentleman in the background, became the word for 2014. What started as a prank has now become a casual thing these days. I recollect my friend saying that he watched all the episodes of Breaking Bad at one stretch and suggested the series to me as well. I wondered, how is it even possible to go at one stretch watching the same series all day and night? But trust me, it is addictive. And when the series is over and you miss that feeling of watching a series continuously, that pain is real. 2015 indicated the change in viewing habit, where people watched a series of 60 episodes in just a couple of days, something in the past would have taken months to complete. Binge watching refers to this mad habit where you start watching one episode and end up completing the entire series. 2016 was thoroughly dominated by US elections, with Trump and Hillary competing for the presidential post, and the word surreal highlighted the events of the election that year. The word surreal means something that is not believable. It is more like things are strange and like in a dream. Maybe it was unbelievable to see the man as a president. All thanks to him, the world got used to the word surreal. Our next word is youthquake. This term stands for a political or a cultural change due to the actions or the influence of youngsters. This word became popular mainly due to the active participation of youngsters in the UK elections. And I'd like to include the Jallikattu protest, which happened in Tamil Nadu the same year. Incidents like these around the world gave rise to this term, and youthquake defined the year 2017. The word toxic was the word for 2018. Toxic is a common word which means harmful, but it is the term toxic masculinity which defined the events of 2018 across the globe. Toxic masculinity means a set of behaviors of men which has a negative impact on other men and the entire society. Hashtag MeToo was used universally during this year. We heard so many complaints and it had its own dark impact on the entire humanity. For 2019, it's a rather simple word, they. The reason is quite interesting. This decade saw the rise of they being used for the third gender. We use he for a man, she for a woman, and people started using they for those who don't identify themselves as either a man or a woman. A great sign indeed. Hopefully, it becomes official in the near future. We have now reached the last year of the decade. Honestly speaking, is one word enough for 2020? I don't guess so. Not after what we have been through this year. Words like quarantine, COVID-8, unmute, Zoom, pandemic, social distancing, mask defined this year. So now, I'll let you decide what is a word that best describes 2020. You tell me what is your word for 2020. You can let me know that in the comment section. If you ask me what is your word for 2020, well, mine is definitely let's learn. Thank you very much for watching this video. Wish you a very happy 2021. I believe with the new decade, things become favorable for you. If you find my work interesting, consider liking and sharing it with your friends and family circle and subscribe to stay connected with Let's Learn.